What's up, guys? It's Cade. Just wanted to get a quick video out this morning because I've been seeing the community get really excited and worked up about Hulk Ragnarok. And I put out a tweet about it this morning with kind of a condensed version of what this video is going to be. But I wanted to kind of get ahead of this excitement a little bit for those of you that are saving for Blade. And tell you why wasting your Blade shards on Hulk Ragnarok isn't necessarily the best idea. Now, if I call him Thor Ragnarok, it's, you know what I mean. It's because he should have been called Gladiator Hulk. And it's tough to keep those two straight. But Hulk Ragnarok, this happens a lot, right? It happened with Carnage. It happened with Cable. It happened with Sentry. The first feature to come out of the two champs, people get really excited for, especially if they've been waiting for him for a long time. The community is so thirsty for good science champs because so many people are sitting on science gems, and the science class has been abysmal up to this point, that people get excited, and they've been excited about this Gladiator Hulk model since he was rumored. And it's kind of, a lot of people end up have been going for him over these past couple of days. Now, in terms of damage, we already know. Seton put out that video. It was 360 some hits at 550 against Realm of Legends Captain Marvel. His damage is bad. Old school Hulk takes her down much, much quicker. So he's not a great damage champ. That was the initial thing. His big advantage comes from a passive ability called Face Me. We were talking about it a little bit on stream last night. Hector then did a video this morning because one of his alliance mates had had Hulk, and he did some testing to kind of see what where he actually shines. And while he's he is niche, he does shine there, right? That's passive damage over time scenarios like Mephisto, Magic, Dormammu, and certain nodes or paths, Starburst, things like that. If you haven't watched Hector's video, it's a great video. Definitely go watch it. But he is niche, and everybody that's getting excited and rolling their Blade shards for him, Blade is going to do in a different way, but is going to do everything that Hulk Ragnarok does in his niche way, but also add a ton of damage to boot and be a Labyrinth path clear. Not only a Labyrinth path clear, but arguably your best option, definitely top two or three for Labyrinth. And that's why I think everybody who's getting really excited and wanting to burn their science gems and going for Hulk Ragnarok, everybody who was saving for Blade, is making a big mistake because Blade is right around the corner. Blade is going to do all of this, and he's going to do it better. Really, the only excuse for not saving for Blade is that you already have a Blade pulled and duped, a 5-star one. So, I wanted to make this video kind of early on enough to maybe help some people out who are kind of on the fence with this whole thing. I'm seeing a lot of excitement for him. And initially, when just the damage numbers were coming out, it was definitely unwarranted. I mean, looks cool. He's a great character model, but once the damage over time thing, the Face Me stuff started coming out, people started testing it, people were getting more excited about him, certainly, but I think only the people that already have Blade pulled and duped should be using their Blade shards to be going to go for Hulk Ragnarok, because again, what he does is niche, and Blade's going to do it in a slightly different way, but he's going to do it, and he has a lot more advantages to boot. Now, Void, for example, was niche as well, but in a very different way. He offered very different things. And Void's, his abilities are, and his stock is only going up because of the Killmonger synergy, things like that. So, whereas Void was a good science champ to go for, again, you definitely, if you needed that utility, because Blade is Blade, right? Those saved shards are very, very important now that, the features are expiring in their classic format, where you had the best chance at a champ by just rolling those featured crystals. Whereas Void kind of offered something different, and he was worthwhile and worth the science gems that people had been holding on to because of that, against someone like Hulk, Ragnarok is not worth wasting those shards on. If you're saving it for Blade, and you certainly should be saving them for Blade if you're if you don't already have him pulled and duped as a 5-star. So anyway, I hope that this was informative. I put out a tweet about it. You see it a lot. People get excited for champs, and I mean, they're cool champs. And Kabam's doing such a fantastic job putting those champs out. But people get excited, and within those first couple days, you see people using up all their chances to get this champ because they like him, and it's fun to roll them. But it's not until a few days later that people really get a feel for the champ once the testing starts coming out and all that. And you get a lot of people who are kind of end up kind of regretting these spins. And this is one that I definitely think you should hold off on, with Blade coming right around the corner. So, all right, I hope that wasn't too long-winded. I tried to keep it as short as I could. Again, I wanted to do this really quick. I didn't even get a chance to get this camera set up and all that. I wanted to get this out because, you know, content is starting to come out on him, and I'm seeing a lot of people wanting to spin for him. So hopefully this is informative. If you're not subbed, I hope you sub. I hope you like this video, and I hope you hit that like button to say so. It definitely helps the channel out. I hope you found all this useful, again, informative, and I will see you guys on the next video. Take care.